Fayetteville High School hasn't always looked as great as it does today. It all began in 1908. The very first building was fairly small and only consisted of 1,304 graduates. In 1939, a new school on Willow Street for African Americans only was named Lincoln High School, which held students first grade through eighth grade. If these students decided to continue their education into high school, they moved on to the all-black Lincoln High School in Fort Smith.
Fayetteville High School was the first school in Arkansas, high school in Arkansas, to fully integrate. Fayetteville had actually, it goes back quite a long way, that Fayetteville was one of the first to even offer a school for black children well before it was going back to the 1800s after the Civil War and Reconstruction. Fayetteville actually had a school for black students, which was unusual in Arkansas. The school was integrated in the mid-50s, and the elementary schools and the rest of the schools in Fayetteville were completely integrated by 1965, which was a first in Arkansas.
I do know that the process was peaceful, but that school district got a lot of criticism both within the state and from around the country. It was publicized, but it was fairly small. There were, I think, seven students that came into the school that first year. However, it's very important because those students had been either living with families in Fort Smith or traveling. I think they all lived down there. The school district paid for them to go to school in Fort Smith because Fayetteville wasn't large enough to have its own African-American high school at that time. And it was the first desegregation in the South. It was the first case.
On May 21st, 1939, the school board decided to integrate African Americans into Fayetteville High School to save the district money. However, only seven African American students attended the following year.
One thing that's really changed over the years has been dress code. Now, I haven't been here that whole time, but I assume that it was here like it was when I was in high school, that we couldn't wear shorts. Dresses had to be a certain length. And probably before that, girls couldn't wear pants to school. Dress code is something that has really changed over the years.
Actually, since I've been at Fayetteville High School, I would say that we have more rules now than we did when I first came. When I first came to Fayetteville High School, the student, and it was kind of a known thing in the area that Fayetteville was much more liberal with its rules than other schools. For instance, we had an open campus for everyone for lunch. We had a work-study program where kids only had to come to school by their senior year. They only had to come to school half a day and they could have a job. They were allowed to smoke in designated areas on campus. So it's much more rule governed now with regard to liberties for the students than it was when I first came here.
One story I always heard about the old high school was that the Bulldog Lobby, which they've tried to preserve in this new building, but back in the day, sophomores were not allowed to walk across the Bulldog. That if you were a sophomore, you could not walk across the Bulldog. You had to go around it. Now, if you were a junior or senior, you could walk straight across it. And when I first came here in 1991, that Bulldog was painted on the floor rather than the tile work that it is now. So every two or three years, they would come in and repaint it because it would wear off the floor. It would start looking really dingy.
We had these lockers, and the lockers would, they had the locks on them, but none of them ever worked. So you would just kind of jimmy your locker by, you know, shaking it a few times and get your locker open. And at the top of the lockers, there was kind of a hidden spot where you could put things that you didn't want other people to find because your locker was pretty much unlocked anyway. So, and it was kind of nice to have lockers. So I actually had, me and other students would share, like if my locker was close to their room, we'd put, you know, our history books in that one and then our algebra books in the other one. So we wouldn't have to carry our books all over the school. We could just keep them in other friends' lockers.
Well, when I came in 1992, and at the time there were students that were actually standing outside, well, right from here, there's a big tree outside the Agri parking lot that students used to stand there and smoke, but then there were complaints from the public about that looks bad. So then they moved it inside into the courtyard by the library, and the students were actually in a confined area, but then the problem was, if it was nice weather, which my room was right above it, the smoke coming from the students smoking down there came up, and you know, air conditioning wasn't turned on a lot of times until it got really hot. So all that smoke from the students smoking came into my room. So that was kind of annoying. But so it had been a variety of different things that have happened. For a while, their students used to run across the street, across Buchanan Street, and smoke over there in other people's yards that let them smoke over there. And then they had new people move in and said, keep the students out of our yards. So you know, we've gone back and forth between smoking being allowed to being not permitted. So
it was what it was. It was an old building that was added onto several times, so it felt that way. It really didn't completely tie together. The levels weren't the same, so there were a lot of stairs up and down just to get to the next floor, just to get to the next hall. You might have to go up two stairs because that's the new part that was added on. I do remember what they're now redoing. So what's phase three, when that part was added on, we were going through kind of what we're doing now. We were under construction while we were in school. And so there would be areas that were hard hat areas. And I remember one of our teachers then, her hall pass was a hard hat. So I remember undergoing that construction.
Another thing is that there were crawl spaces under the school. There were crawl spaces behind the lockers in some places. So if you took the back off a locker, you could get back there and go in behind the lockers and travel around the school. In the old library, we had a door that was kind of up in the wall. It was a little short door up in the wall, and we always called it the Hobbit Hole. But it actually led to a tunnel that ran kind of behind some of the classrooms, and it was dirt. The floor was clay, I guess. So those are some things I know.
So I remember undergoing that construction. One of my favorite things about the old building, and one of the things I really miss now, is I felt like it said, students, go here. There were murals on the walls that the students painted. Teachers could request, or different areas, like let's say the math wing could request a mural, and the students would paint something. So there was a lot of things in the old building that said, this is a place for students.
I think we lost some of our quirkiness. We lost things like the murals and just some things that character that the school had because it had been around for 50, 60 years. But this school's beautiful. I mean, the views, like here in the library, are beautiful. And I think there's a real mix. But I think we need to do something to liven up the place. It's awfully gray.
I think it was a good deal. The only problem I had was that, you know, when they started dynamiting down there to actually build the foundation, that the contractors went, oh my gosh, there's rock underneath this Fayetteville High School, which was like big surprise, there's rock under everything in Arkansas. But when they started dynamiting, they had a crack went across the third floor in the math department, and where we had never had a leak, all of a sudden it was like, so I think they cracked the ceiling. I don't know how they're gonna repair that. They can try to tar it or whatever, but there's some damage. So I was excited, like it's gonna be new, but you're using the same old concrete foundation, which I think for the most part is gonna be okay, but I think some damage has happened from a lot of the explosions and things that happened. So I'm worried that the foundation may not be as strong as a new building.
I can't really predict the future because we have ninth graders coming in next year. Will we have the space adequate for everybody? Will we have enough technology to go around. So those are questions that I can't really predict yet, but they're certainly important questions. I just don't know the answers to them. I mean, it's like, and I'm certainly not pessimistic about it, but we have a lot of issues. And it's not, I mean, this is a very large school, but we have so many new kids coming in, we're just gonna have to see how it works out. There's gonna be some growing pains.
When I started teaching it here, we had TI, or they were 8386s, and they had 1 kilobyte of memory. And you had disks that you had to put in to load the programs, because they just virtually had nothing. You had green screens. I mean, you had no graphics or anything else. It was pretty much just programming language, and we went from there to where we are now. It was just like tremendous advances in technology, and that it's been a great, because we've had a lot of improvements. We had a technology budget that's been trying to keep up, but as fast as technology changes, it makes it difficult to, you know, to be able to purchase all the things we want to stay up.
Everything's got to change, and this building is beautiful, and we can start by making new artwork and things like that. But this building is, you know, it's kind of a big maze, but it's very beautiful, and I really prefer it to the old high school.
Renovations for the school are constantly in progress. Beginning in the 1990s, FHS decided to make additional renovations which would create the multiple phases we have today. Phase 1 was built in 2012, Phase 2 was built in 2013, Phase 3 was built in 2014, and Phase 4 is scheduled to open in 2015.
Well, I think it's all been real positive in technology. I mean, we just keep advancing like the rest of the world does in technology. As far as the rules, we used to always pride FHS because of the fact that we always said you're getting to be adults by the time you leave, you're 18.
There are so many more choices for students that we didn't have when I was young. There are so many more AP classes that kids can take to get a leg up on their college. Many more different kind of ways in which students can focus on the things they're more interested in. The SLCs, I think, are a great positive thing for this school. And I would have loved to have been more focused like that when I was in high school if we had the SLCs way back then.
We try to go from a transition to where we are telling you what to do to where we expect you to be more independent. And I think part of that was the open campus thing that you're responsible to leave. Yeah, but so I think that in some ways, because I guess the peer pressure, public pressure was that they wanted to close the campus, that's taken away some of the things that we let students show that their independence. And by keeping seniors being allowed to be the ones that live campus, I think we're still doing similar things, but now that's out because they've said that their seniors will no longer leave campus.
I think there was good things. There have been good things that were considered part of the past, and I think there are good things that are considered now, and I think there are good things that are considered part of the future. So I can't really say whether it's better or worse. It is what it is. There were things I like that are gone, but there are things that are new that weren't there in the past that I like as well. So I think that we are making good efforts at technology. I think we have a long way to go with regard to access for all students. I think we have a long way to go. I think it's very hard to keep up with technology now because change is every day, several times a day. So I think that we have a lot of strides we need to make there. For instance, in some of our computer applications classes, they don't have the technology that kids have at home. So we're teaching kids old systems that are obsolete. So I think that's a challenge for schools because it's very costly, but I think that's something that we constantly have to watch. And I think that we also, what I'm seeing in the new building, for example, is we have access to new technology, like we have laptops in the rooms, but we don't, the wireless doesn't always work. So there, it's a moot point. We don't really have access to the laptop. So I think those kind of kinks are going to have to be worked out to make it better. I think that we are doing a better job of recognizing what challenges a large campus brings. I see a much better job this year than last year of monitoring the school grounds, knowing where, like last year it felt to me like kids could skip school on campus. They didn't have to leave campus to skip anymore. They could skip while they were here because there were so many places they could hide out. I feel like now we have kind of found better ways to deal with that. And so as we see the new challenges, it does feel to me like we're doing a better job of meeting the new challenges.
With over 100 years of classes, Fayetteville High School is getting better and better every year. And with a fully completed high school within sight, Fayetteville High School's future is looking pretty bright.